Hello all and welcome back to Live Travel India. So following the Delhi Darshan series, today I'm gonna explore the Safdarjung Tomb. Located at the intersection of Safdarjung Road and Aurobindo Marg, the Safdarjung Tomb is easily accessible by metro. So if you are planning to visit here, then get off at the Jorbag metro station and walk straight from here. As the tomb is at a short distance from the metro station, so I decided to walk from here. Safdarjung Tomb is one of the few buildings built during the last span of the Mughal era. This Safdarjung Ka Maqbara or Safdarjung Tomb was built in memorial of Safdarjung, who was the governor of the province Awadh under the ruler Muhammad Shah. Safdarjung's original name was Mirza Mukim Abul Mansur Khan. He was very rich and most powerful. He was an independent ruler of Awadh as the viceroy of Muhammad Shah. As this Safdarjung Ka Maqbara is maintained by the Archaeological Survey of India, so before going in, first you have to buy the tickets from this counter. The tickets are of rupees 25 for each person. With the death of Emperor Muhammad Shah, Safdarjung moved to Delhi. He died in 1754 and after his death, his son Nawab Shuja-ud built this tomb in memorial of his father, and this tomb was designed by an Arabic architect. The plan of the tomb structure is similar to that of the Humayun's tomb, and if you have ever visited the Sikandra in Agra, which is in Uttar Pradesh, then you can find many similarities in the architecture of this tomb and that of the Sikandra. Safdarjung Tomb is basically a garden tomb and has several smaller pavilions like Jungli Mahal, Moti Mahal and Badshah Pasan. Also, the complex has a madarsa just like any other ancient Mughal monuments. And there is also a library over the main gateway where we bought the tickets first. The garden surrounding the entire tomb complex is very beautiful, clean and green, and is a very aesthetic landscape for photography. You can also come here with your friends and with your DSLRs, with your cameras, and click some cool pictures from Instagram handle just like I did. Oh, and yes, you don't have to pay any extra penny for photography or videography if you are capturing the photos and videos from your mobile phones. But if you are carrying a DSLR or any other professional camera, or you are here for any kind of professional shooting like film shooting or documentaries or short film shooting, then you have to pay rupees 25 for each DSLR or for each camera. Outside the monument from the counter where we bought the tickets. The chambers inside the tomb are rectangular in shape, and the corner chambers are in octagonal shape. Also, there are two graves inside the tomb, one that of Safdarjung and the other one is of his wife. tomb complex is well maintained, so clean, and the architecture here is so beautiful. But I don't know why this beautiful monument is less visited by people, and generally the place is less crowded. Moreover, most of the people living in Delhi don't even know about this place. So if you love historical places and love finding more about the beauty of Mughal architecture just like me, then add this Safdarjung Tomb to your bucket list and plan your visit ASAP. So this was all about the Safdarjung Tomb. Stay connected to Live Travel India for finding out about more such undiscovered places. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Also, it would be great if you like and share this video too. Thank you.